absolutely fantastic day. Incredible, beautiful. I'm at Cadell in South Australia, next to the Murray River. This is about 12 to 15 kilometres from Morgan, where I normally shoot. What you can see here is a floodplain, sort of a backwater to the Murray. There are a number of connections in the distance where this water body joins directly onto the Murray. And normally, through the channels, there'll be a little bit of water coming here, not directly here, but a bit further down. And ordinarily, you wouldn't see any water as far as those dead trees. But the river levels have come up so much in the last few weeks that this has now become quite a lagoon. 3 weeks ago, I could have driven to those dead trees, parked, walked around, had a look about, but not now. I'd need a boat now, or big rubber boots. So it's a beautiful place, it's really fascinating. And the reason that I want to have a look here and show you is that I want to really look at the ants. I'm fascinated by ants and how they deal with situations like this. I don't know whether they all move. I sort of find that a bit hard to believe. I think they probably end up getting underground and maybe sealing off. Some species will be capable of moving brood up into the dead trees, up into the branches and maybe some of the vegetation. But I think others that couldn't do that, there are some species that simply wouldn't do that. They'll probably just seal off, or as I'm seeing here, and you'll see soon, they're moving. And I don't know whether they're moving to higher ground. It doesn't really look that way. I think more than likely what they're doing is they're moving to a more suitable nesting site, to a site maybe that goes deeper into the ground, where they can actually seal it off and keep the water out. Because they know it's happening, man. These ants are pretty clever. They know this water's on the way, and they're doing something about it. Incredible stuff. So, let's have a look at the footage I've taken of these ants. Let's have a look. So the ant we can see here is a species of Rhytidopanera. I don't know which species it is. It's interesting because it's halfway between the two common ones that I know. A lot of people will be familiar with Rhytidopanera metallica, which is commonly known as the green-headed metallic ant, I think it's called that, or the green-headed ant. It's quite small, it's found in most of your urban areas, it's very, very common. These guys are in between metallica, the common one, and a large one that I find in the Mallee called Rhytidopanera mayeri. And it seems to be that the larger these ants are, the less there are of them. It's almost as if the biomass of the colony remains constant by altering the numbers of individuals. Whether that's true or not, I don't know. It'll certainly make an interesting study. So there's a fair number of these guys because they're sort of intermediate in size. And here what we can see they're doing is they're clearly moving their eggs out. Every now and then you'll see one shoot up to the left-hand top corner and takes an egg out. I didn't manage to see exactly where they were taking them. But the ground there, you can see the soil is damp. And this was probably only about 2 meters from the water's edge. So these ants now have to move because that flood water is encroaching on them. Won't be long, another probably 3, 4, 5 days, and this nest may well be underwater. You can see one here with a larvae in the middle there with that white larvae, whereas the long brown light case they're carrying in the top left hand corner, that's a pupal case. So the larvae becomes a pupa, turns into a pupa, and then the pupa eventually hatches into an adult. It's also top left hand corner, you can see one there now, it's carrying eggs. There's a bunch of eggs that are stuck together. It's on top of that snail. So they're moving eggs, they're moving larvae, and they're moving the pupae, they're moving the whole lot. I also saw one of them carrying another ant, which is something that a lot of ants do. It's quite interesting. I always thought that it was to do with maybe the ant that's being carried doesn't know the way. I thought maybe there was a type of ant that just didn't come outside and didn't know the outside environment. Although researchers seem to think that it's a way of saving energy, that it's like having two people in one car paying for fuel rather than just having one person. And because the colony is like one entire organism, one whole organism, and the ants are subunits, then the energy used for the entire colony would be reduced if they shared transport costs. So that's a possibility. Another species I noticed today that was very active in this area surrounding these floodwaters was this meat ant, Iridomimix viridianus. I didn't quite know what it was when I first saw it. It looked a little bit reddish in the light, and then when I managed to see it in the shade, I could see which species it was. Often quite difficult with these. I think out of all the ants that are in this area, this species will probably deal with the flooding the most efficiently. Probably because they're already set up in such a manner with their integrated nesting system that movement between nests is probably not going to be a great big deal for them. I think they'll deal with it fairly easily. One of the reasons that meat ants are so successful and such an ecologically dominant species. This last species I'm going to show you in this video is a species of Camponotus. This is Camponotus epipinum. It's quite a distinctive species. It has a reddish coloured thorax, and the anterior end, the front end of the thorax, is widened, so it's this kind of triangular shape. And they just have a look about them. There's two or three species within this species group that all have that kind of same look to them. I felt very lucky today in finding these, because normally I'll see one or two here or there. They're very scattered, you don't see them very often, and I've never been able to trace one back to any kind of nest because there's never been enough of them to actually do that. But today these guys are really, really busy, and I wouldn't be surprised if it's due to this rising flood water. But it's no wonder I haven't seen their nest, because this nest is just so incredibly cryptic. I had no idea that it was there until I saw the ants. No accumulation of debris, no ant mound. They haven't put these leaves there. This is just leaf litter underneath of a tree, the way they've fallen, and the ants have built their nest in under there. So you just would not know that was an ant nest unless you saw the activity. In the middle here we see an alate queen. She's huge compared to the workers. So basically she's a reproductive female, which is called alate because alate means winged. And she's meant to fly away from the colony and start a new colony. So I don't know why she's lagging behind. This activity is not nuptial flight related. There's not enough of them. This is more to do with, I think, probably food collecting, clearing out the nest, maybe in preparation for flooding. So you can see there, that alate queen's just been dragged out by a worker. So the worker's saying, look, you know, your time here's done, you've got to leave, we can't look after you, you have to go and start a new colony, that's your job. Very, very interesting species, and I'm very glad that I saw them. If it weren't for this degree of activity, I would never have found this nest.